Hello and welcome to another section of Performance Booster. Today we'll talk about a very typical problem that comes mostly every year, and this is a very simple trick to solve these questions, or this question in particular. Always you will find that they will give a little bit trick about this and they will all follow the same technique. So if you know the technique, you can do all of them. So today we'll help you to understand the technique behind it. It may involve any question, any sort of transformation, but the same trick will apply to any sort of transformation. See the question carefully. If you have seen the question, this is also a question of JEE Advanced 2018, question number 11, if you want to cross check from your question paper. So it is asking you to give the amount of D from 10 moles of acetophenone, which is a starting material, and it is given the yield of all of the steps. Firstly, you need to understand what will form, because you will molecular weight of D you need to understand for this question. So you should know the reaction sequence first of all. That is the first thing you need to know in this question. In the second, it is just a simple technique that you apply. If you know the reaction sequence, apply the technique. It's a two-line question. Okay, so first let us look at the reaction sequence. So we have an acetophenone. We apply NaBr4BrH3O+. You know by now, what does it do? It converts it to an acid. So firstly, it produces sodium salt of the acid, and then we have a H3O+, which converts it to an acid. Then what is given? We have an ammonia. We know very well, on heating this with ammonia, it converts it to an amide. These are very simple reactions, so we are not going into the formula. Then we have bromine KOH. Now if you know very well, what does it do? It converts it to an amine. And you know very well, what is this step called? This is Hoffmann rearrangement. This is a very easy and important rearrangement that you know by now. And then we are giving three equivalents of bromine, that is excess of bromine in presence of ACOH. What does it do? It creates a tribrominated product around the aniline. With bromine at the two ortho positions, since it is ortho para directing, and at the one para position. So this is our final D, or this the amount of which we have to calculate. Okay, so this is our reaction sequence. So how do we go about this problem? That is our main point of view. It's very easy. It's a very simple technique that I will tell you. It will solve most of the similar questions that can arrive at your exams. Let us look at the technique then. It is said the starting material is given in 10 moles. So the first step, the A is produced, is 60%. So what is the amount of A produced? It is 60% of 10 moles. How much it is? So how much it is? It is 6 moles. 6 moles of A is produced. As it is said, it is the reaction of the yield is 60%. So how much of B is produced? That is 50% of 6 moles. You go to this reaction sequence sequentially, and one step. It will help you in solving the question. First of all, we have 10 moles. Amount of A, how much A did we get? It is 60% conversion, or 60% yield. So how much A did we get? 6 moles. Now, 6 moles of A converted to B with a yield of 50%. So how much B did we get? Is 50% of this 6 moles. So how much it is? 3 moles, you got the trick by now. Let us see amount of C. It's the same as this. So it is 50% of now 3 moles. That is 1.5 moles. This is the amount of C. Now D is produced at 100% yield. That is, whatever amount of C we got, that is the amount of D we get. If we got 1.5 moles of C, so the amount of D must be 1.5 moles only, because it is 100% of 1.5 moles. So this is our final moles. So we get 1.5 moles of D. And we have to calculate the amount of D. So we got 10 moles of D. We have to calculate the amount of the gram of D, or the weight of the substance of D in grams. What is D? Let us draw again. What is D? D is this. It's a tribrominated aniline. First, let us calculate the molecular weight of this. Let us go one by one. How many carbons do we have? C6. How many hydrogens? One here, and two here. So C6H4. How many nitrogens? One, and we have Br3. If we calculate this, this is 72 plus 4
plus nitrogen is 14 plus bromine, each bromine is 80, so 3 bromine is 240, which comes to around, if you do your calculations, 340 is the molecular weight of T. How many moles do we have of D? We have 1.5 moles of D. What is the question tell us? The question tells us to find out the amount of D in grams. So we simply just multiply this amount of moles with the molecular weight. What is the answer you get? So you calculated wrong. 1.5 moles of D is equivalent to 1.5 and 330. 330 is the molecular weight of this tribromo anilated product that I drew in the last some minutes before. So the answer is 495 grams of T. So here you just write 495. 495 is the final answer. So this is how you solve these questions, which ask you to find the amount of the product. You simply go by going through sequentially what is the yield given. So you calculate the number of moles. Also, you can do by understanding each of the molecular weight, by calculating each of the molecular weight, and then by seeing how much yield is converted. That is also right, but I feel that is more strenuous. So first of all, through the yields, you calculate the number of moles of the product that is formed. So you finally calculate the number of moles, and then you just multiply with the molecular weight of the last step. If you go through and calculate each of the molecular weight of each of the steps and then calculate the yield, it will become strenuous, and also you might do some simple silly mistakes like stereo. So don't do this, just calculate the number of moles for the final case and then just find the molecular weight of the final product, and you have the amount of the final product. These are some simple techniques that you do to solve these questions. These are very simple questions, don't miss them out. This will give you very easy marks, and these are the questions come mostly every year, alternate year, and these all follow the same techniques to go through. So you just need to know the reaction sequence, or you need to know the final product, that is more important. And only you will know the final product if you know the reaction sequence. And then you just go through this technique, calculate the number of moles, find the molecular weight of the final product, just calculate the amount of the product. Thank you. I hope you had fun. So do catch us at our next session. Thank you and all the best.